Today's hymns at St. Bridget's are 286, 382, 12, and 573. And today's readings, Isaiah 40, parts 12 to 17 and 27 to 31, Psalm 8, 2, Corinthians 13, part 11 to 13, and Matthew 28, part 16 to 20.
Good morning, everyone, and I'd just like to gather you all here quickly. I'm naturally quite forgetful, so I thought I'd better publish some bans of marriage first, so I wouldn't forget. Otherwise, I'll be in big trouble. Yeah, but I'm always in trouble anyway, so it's fine. I'm used to it. So, I've got two bans that I wish to publish. I publish the bans of marriage between Matthew John James White Ash Olivia Obrero of Bryn, Môr Mission Area and of the Diocese of Bath and of the Parish of Bath. This is the first time of asking if any of you know any reason in law why they may not marry each other, you are to declare it. This is the first time of reading it. I publish the bans of marriage between Simon Richard Clark, single of the Bryn, Môr Mission Area, and Sarah Leash Mason, single of Tooting. This is the first time of asking. If any of you know of any reason in law why they should not marry each other, you are to declare it. Okay. Wonderful. Thank you very much. And I'll now hand you over to the capable hands of Roger.
A very warm welcome to St. Bridget's this morning on this Trinity Sunday. And we thank again to Revd Gregor, who will be celebrating for us the Eucharist. And as it's the first Sunday of the month, can I remind you that coffee and cake will be served in the transept after the service, and you're all most welcome to join if you're able to stay. Notices for the week, fairly straightforward. Midweek Eucharist as usual at 10 o'clock, that's Wednesday the 7th of June. On also the 7th is the meeting of the Church Council, which takes place at 11 o'clock in the morning. Next Sunday is the first opportunity, and our Sunday Eucharist as usual will be 10 o'clock. And can I remind you that the licensing of the Reverend David Lewis takes place in Parnassus Church at 7 o'clock on the 8th of June. Bishop will be presiding and preaching, and you're all most welcome to attend that. Now, moment of quietness while we begin our service.
Thank you.
You've had with me. I'd like you all just to pray for me, please. Pray for David, pray for Adrian, pray for David Ash. Just pray for your priests in the mission area as we begin, as we have, all have new beginnings. That will have its challenges, but we hope to do it with joy and with thanksgiving. So let us pray together now. Father of glory,
holy and eternal, look upon us now in power and mercy. May your strength overcome our weakness, your radiance transform our blindness, and your spirit draw us to that love shown and not to us by your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you give light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Us prepare ourselves and our hearts as we confess our sins. And we pray together. Heavenly Father,
we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and have failed to do what we ought to have done. We are sorry and truly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and lead us in his way to walk as children of light. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you and set you free from sin, strengthen you in goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Christ, our Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Glory of God the Father.
you have given us your servants grace, by the confession of a true faith, to acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity, and in the power of the divine majesty to worship the unity. Keep us steadfast in this faith, that we may evermore be defended from all adversaries, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Please sit for our first reading.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Who has measured the waters in the hollow of his hand, and marked off the heavens for the span, enclosed the dust of the earth in a measure, weighed the mountains in scales and the hills in a balance? Who has directed the Spirit of the Lord, or as his counselor has instructed him? Whom did he consult for his enlightenment? Who taught him the path of justice, taught him knowledge, and showed him the way of understanding? Behold, the nations are like a drop from a bucket, and are accounted as the dust on the scales. Behold, he takes up the isles like the fine dust. Lebanon would not suffice for fuel, nor are its beasts enough for a burnt offering. All the nations are as nothing before him. They are accounted by him as less than nothing and emptiness. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel? My way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youths shall faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, you gave your son power over the works of your hand.
You gave your son power over the works of your hand.
How great is your name, O Lord our God, through all the earth. Your majesty is praised above the heavens, on the lips of children and of babes. You have found praise to foil your enemy.
You gave your son power over the works of your hands.
When I see the heavens, the work of your hands, the moon and the stars which you arranged, what is man that you should keep him in mind, mortal man that you care for him?
You gave your son power over the works of your hand.
Yet you have made him little less than a god. With glory and honor you crowned him, gave him power over the works of your hand, put all things under his feet.
You gave your son power over the works of your hand.
A reading from St. Paul's second letter to the Corinthians. Finally, brothers and sisters, farewell. Mend your ways, heed my appeal, agree with one another, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the saints greet you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Gradual Hymn, number 382. Lord, who is, who was, and who is to come.
Alleluia.
Gospel of Christ according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him. But some doubted. Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, to the close of the age." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Father, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. Thank you. Please be seated. In the Gospel reading for this Trinity Sunday, we are presented with the last words spoken by Jesus on earth before his ascension. And these are words which are so remarkable and so poignant that they deserve our attention. All of it, all of these words deserve our attention because it's the great commission of Christ. And this is the foundation of mission in which we as Christians base our calling. This is what Christ has commanded all believers to do. It's my last Sunday with you before I'm set loose into the world. And in a sense, these are the last words which I have for you. So thank you. Thank you for letting me be part of your family, and I will always remain part of your family. I only live up there. I'm not going anywhere. I am, but I'm not. If you know what I mean, I'm still a missionary. So, you know, you'll always have my ear if you need it. It's revealed to us in Scripture that God had put great honor and authority on Jesus. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me." God gave Jesus authority over heaven and earth. Based on that authority, Jesus told his disciples to make more disciples as they preached, baptized, and taught. And with this same authority, Jesus still commands us to tell others of the good news of the gospel and to make people disciples of the kingdom of God. Through this, we know of Jesus' true divinity. This is a declaration through God in the Trinity that Jesus is the Son of Man and is appointed as heir of all things, that he is the mediator between God and all humankind. The knowledge that the salvation of all who are saved is laid upon Christ through his sacrifice on the cross. It is by his grace, his mercy, his life, and the peace that he brings that we are saved through him, if we truly believe in him. It is through this joy of the knowledge of his grace that he endured the cross for us. It is through the sacrifice that the truth of the gospel that Jesus obtained the keys to life and death, to heaven and hell. Jesus, through the authority of God, is anointed. He has anointed the great high priest who alone can absolve our sins. He is the living water in whom we can be made clean. Christ is the Prince of Peace. He is the Saviour of the world, who alone can give repentance and remission of our sins. In him all scripture is fulfilled. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the Good Shepherd. And by his authority, those who have Christ in their life have life. If you've got Christ in your life, you have life. You have eternal life. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Jesus commissions his disciples not to keep the knowledge of salvation to themselves. He commands them to go out and to tell the world, to make it known throughout the kingdom of all people. To make disciples of all nations. To tell people that Christ died for all sinners. This command is unchanged and is still in place. It's the sacred duty of every single disciple to do all that they can personally and in prayer to bring others to Christ. Jesus is Lord. Are his disciples letting the world know this? Are we letting the world know that Jesus is Lord? Jesus requires a public profession of those who believe in the gospel. We do this through our baptisms, our confirmations, the renewal of our baptism vows. When we look at Jesus' last command to his disciples, it is clear that we are to be baptized in the name of the Holy Trinity. Baptisms and confirmations are public. They are a public declaration of the faith of the church. All who are members receive baptism. We had the honour and privilege last week of welcoming Arthur into the family of the church last week. He and his family, his godparents and our church family made known our professions of faith. Our profession of faith in God the Father, God the Son and God the Holy Spirit. Being baptised and telling the world the good news. Tell the world the good news of Jesus is obedience to God. Telling the world the good news of Jesus Christ is obedience to God. Baptism has united all believers with Christ. And teaching them to obey everything that I've commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age. Jesus needs us all who profess the faith to be obedient to him. We're not called to be secret Christians. We must not be ashamed of our faith. We must show the world who we serve. We must not only be obedient to God, but we must be obedient to his word and his gospel. And this is not just saying, I am a Christian, but true obedience to God is how we practice our faith, how we live out a gospel life in service to him and his church. The water of baptism, the bread and wine of the Lord's Supper, it will not save anyone's soul alone. We achieve nothing if we only go to church, listen to the priest's sermon and approve of the gospel message and then go no further than that in our journey of faith. How do we live our lives each day? How do we conduct ourselves? Do we strive each day to emulate Christ's example? Do we seek to do the things that he commanded? Do we acknowledge our shortcomings and sins? Don't ever separate your public life from the life you have as a Christian. as a disunited way of life, and it takes you away from the love of God. As a church and as part of the mission area, I will ask you to remain united, to pray for and uphold one another, to bear each other's burdens. Help us priests make new disciples. Help us to nurture and help. Help us to flourish our communities, especially here in Dyserth, especially in Melodon, Prestatyn, Trelawnyd, Thanasa, Wanesker, Finadroyu, Trelogan. All these places in our community, they need flourishing. They need God. They need to be known and let known of the love of God. Four vicars can't do it alone. Such a large geographical area. Study your Bibles. Talk to God every day. Pray for your priests. But most of all, be kind to yourselves and love one another as you love yourself. And do this in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand as we affirm the faith of the Church.
We believe in one God, the Father the Almighty, maker of the heavens and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray.
Let us pray to God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. God in three persons, Blessed Trinity, you are God, the Creator, you are Christ, the Redeemer, you are the Spirit of truth and love. We bring before you the needs of the Church in its weakness and in its potential. Revive and refresh us. Teach and direct us. Inspire all who teach and preach the good news, and uphold all who suffer for their faith in any way. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We bring before you, O God, the particular problems of our age and culture. Renew in us the commitment to community and to mutual trust. Give a sense of value to all who despise others and themselves. Protect the vulnerable and sensitise the hearts of all who have been hardened by images of violence. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for all those who are ill and known to us. Abby Tinman, Abby Green, Alison Williams, Andrew Morgan, Brenda Fox, Chloe, Christine Bromett, Christine Price, Cliff Pilkinson, Dale Sanderson, David Murphy, Dawn Murphy, Doreen Hicks, Harry Sanford, Jack Buckley, Jackie Parry, Jean Meredith, Jennifer and Esmaya Field, John Tallon, Jos Code, Karen Huckabee, Keith and Frieda Sanderson, Kit Hopkins, Lillian Wally, Lynn Limbury, Lisa Foy, Malcolm Bremner, Michael Sweeney, Mike Peters, Oliver Smith, Rosemary Chapman, Sarah Dennis, Sophie Thompson, Sue Evans, Terry and Edwina Williams, Timothy Lipscomb, priest, Tony McGuinness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We bring before you, O God, the nurturing of our children and young people, in homes and parenting, in schools and teaching, in the expectations, pressures and dangers, in the hopes and possibilities for good. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for those who suffer from oppression or the inequalities of society. Grant them relief and give them freedom in body and mind. Have mercy on all those who have been led astray by mistaken beliefs and bring them to the true faith. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for the departed who in this world held fast to the faith of the Holy Trinity. We pray particularly for the recently departed Sam Bowen. May their example strengthen and prepare us for the coming of joy made complete and love made perfect in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather of the crumbs on your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to refresh your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we therefore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Please stand for the peace. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always to the close of the age. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with you also.
Let us offer one another a sign of God's peace.
The offertory hymn, number 12.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
God our Father, as with these gifts we declare the death of our Lord Jesus Christ, until he comes, grant us to share now in part of the last in fullness, in the blessings and glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We worship and pray. All worship and praise belong to you, Father. In every place and at all times, all power is yours. You created the heavens and established the earth. You sustain in being all that is. In Christ your Son, our life and yours are brought together in a wonderful exchange. He made us home among us, that we might forever dwell with you. Through your Holy Spirit, you call us to new birth in creating a creation restored by love. As children of your redeeming purpose, we offer you our praise with angels and archangels in the company of heaven, singing the hymn of your unending glory.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Glory and thanksgiving be to you, most loving Father, for the gift of your Son born as man. He is the Word existing beyond time, both source and final purpose, bringing to wholeness all that is made. Obedient to your will, he died upon the cross. By your power, you raised him from the dead. He broke the bonds of evil and set your people free to be his body in the world. And on the night he was given up to death, knowing that his hour had come, having loved his own, he loved them to the end. And at supper with his disciples, he took bread and offered you thanks. He broke the bread and gave to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given up for you." Saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." The mystery of faith. Christ has died,
Christ is risen, Christ will come in glory.
Now obey your Son's command, and recalling his blessed passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and we look for his coming in his kingdom, made one with him, we offer you these gifts, and with them ourselves, a single, holy, living sacrifice.
Hear us, most merciful Father, and send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon this bread and wine, that overshadowed by his life-giving power, they may be the body and blood of your Son, and may be kindled with the fire of your love and renewed for the service of your kingdom. Help us, who are baptized into the fellowship of Christ's body, to live and work to your praise and glory. May we grow together in unity and love, and so at last in your new creation, we enter into our heritage in the company of the Virgin Mary, the apostles and prophets, St. Bridget and St. Cwyfan, and all our brothers and sisters living and departed, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, with him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
And as our Savior taught us, we boldly pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, but we will share in one bread.
Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us.
Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us.
Jesus,
Redeemer of the world, give us your peace.
Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say a word, and I shall be healed.
Our prayer for today, Holy God, faithful and unchanging, enlarge our minds with the knowledge of your truth, and draw us more deeply into the mystery of your love, that we may truly worship you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Oh, my soul prays to you for he is mine.
do it from the lectern. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious.
His love is everlasting.
Living God, for all, for our redemption, you gave your only begotten Son to the death of the cross. By his glorious resurrection, you have delivered us from the power of our enemy. Grant us so to die daily to sin, that we may more live with him and the joy of his risen life. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God of truth,
we have seen with our eyes and touched with our hands the bread of life.
Strengthen our faith,
that we may grow in love for you and for each other. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
God the Father, by whose glory Christ was raised from the dead, strengthen you to walk with him and his risen life. And the blessing of God Almighty, abendeth you, ho hath beog, akirtad, yermad, arasukwai. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
So go in peace, to love and serve the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
In the name of Christ, hallelujah, hallelujah.